Alrighty, thanks for getting back with us. We're back from the break. This is Larry with Spiritually Speaking on the Edge Broadcasting Network. And today we have a fantastic guest with us. Her name is Ann Cruz, and she co-authored a book called Bible and Numbers. And we have her on here today to explain the book and get some more information about how this number situation works here in the Bible. Ann, you with us?
Well, you know, we've been doing a lot of calculations. So bear with me, I'm French, so I have a French accent.
Okay.
And we the other day I was thinking, you know, we're just pondering about all of our calculations. Excuse me. And really what just dawned on me, we've been counting the days just like in the book of Daniel. See, the book of Daniel tells you to count the days. And, you know, that's what it is. We count the days, and by counting the days, starting for certain days, and you know, the Lord just chose us the days to start counting from, and we found some codes. We call those numbers, this amount of days, like for example, 144 days, 153 days. We call these codes, because a code is a piece of information, and you know, we have seen that those codes confirm each other. It's just, it's mind-boggling. It's really, you know, I've had my mind blown, I mean, over and over when I discovered this code, because we have seen it, our calendar is just riddled with encoded days, you know, certain amount of days added to make a year, and those days, we call them sacred biblical numbers, because they're found in the Bible. And our book, it just centers around the number 153, and the number 153 is, you know, in John 21st chapter. And we have found out ever since 9/11 that God has showed us that 9/11 is all the encoding of the rapture, which means that I believe that since 9/11 is all the encoding of the rapture, and since the rapture we mark the countdown to the day of the Lord according to Daniel, 9/11 itself is marked, it's a countdown to the rapture.
That's interesting. Well, how'd you get started in all the number equations and getting and dissecting this? How'd that all come across?
Well, it started with my friend Gerard, and he's been, you know, putting some notes, writing on some notes for 30 years. And it started with the numbers, the simple numbers Jesus Christ, which is 151. And the next number was 144, which is the number of angel and of man. And the third number we started with is 153, which is the number of the rapture. And, you know, she just kept on and searching and seeking, you know, looking at the world major events and counting the days and, you know, coming up with some kind of pattern. Say, I believe we are living in a huge matrix because everything is so ordained and it's God's order. And, of course, since God has created numbers, you know, he placed his own order within the days, every day, everything we do, every day. I mean, you know, every day is encoded, and I have, you know, I call this ticking the dates.
Mm-hmm.
In ticking the dates, I found out that my life has the same encoding as some numbers that are mentioned in my book, which, you know, by the time some of those dates occurred, I would never know that one day I would write a book about them. It was funny, yesterday I saw the movie, Well, you know, my life is a little like the guy on 23, you know, you see number everywhere, and, you know, you see your life. Mm-hmm. And that's what I see numbers not everywhere. And also, I have found out that, you know, Gerard and I, we have found some many codes, and we have found out that sometimes we find some, like a third-party information, and it confirms those codes, and which tells us that we were right all along.
Hmm.
And, like, those codes are just like that, like check and balances that confirming each other.
Well, I did like in your book, I told you when I talked to you yesterday that I did read your book a little bit, and to be honest with you, a lot of it, it's kind of a little over my head, and that's not just the quality of your book, I think it's the mind reading it, but I did like in the very beginning on the book where you talked about evolution, and you said numbers were born whole from the beginning. I'd like to repeat, there's no such thing as a one after that 3 gazillion years or eons of loyal service has been promoted to a number two.
Yeah.
I found that quite interesting. I never heard, obviously, I can only assume that you're a creationist in heart, and I've never heard it put that quite that way. That was quite interesting. That quite caught my attention when I read that. So you said you're originally from France, you said?
Yes.
Okay, when did you come to the United States?
Well, my husband's American.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, when he retired, we moved back to America.
So he worked over in France. That's where you met him at.
I met him in Geneva, Switzerland. So that's a long story.
Okay. Okay. And so how did you you said you see numbers a lot in the and you look at things. I mean, what drove you to write this book?
Well, you know, when I got born again in 2003, I've got to give me something that I knew I would enjoy doing. And that's 2 weeks later, I was looking for the tumor history on the internet, and I never clicked on the link, but instead I found that link, which was called Bible et Nombre, which means Bible and numbers.
Mm-hmm.
And I started reading the website, and actually this was Gérard's website.
Mm-hmm.
And I loved it so much. I told myself, I've never seen the Bible, you know, explained like that, with dates and numbers. And, you know, to tell you the truth and to put you at ease, maybe, I flunked 1 year school because of math, so I'm not too good in math. I mean, those numbers are just counting, so, you know.
Uh-huh.
And if me, poor little me, who can write a book about numbers, and I am not a mathematician, can make a book, such a book, everybody can understand my book. I mean, you know, and I have explained it, and I have introduced the numbers little by little, you know, and it's just like a progression. And at the end, it's really a fireworks, I think so. Because, you know, I add... Everything comes together at the end of the book.
I see. Okay. Well, I noticed in your book, I'm looking at the table of contents as you were talking there, and I noticed you break them down into several categories, the number 666, the New World Order, which we speak a lot about on the Edge Broadcasting Network on our flagship show, which is called The Edge with Daniel Ott. And I see Mark of the Beast and so forth and so on as we go on down here. Could you explain a little bit? I'm interested in understanding the chapter 666. Obviously, everyone who's got any kind of information about biblical text or even watched any horror movies for that matter will know what 666 means. And the verse you used in the beginning of that chapter said, "Here is wisdom. Let him that understandeth count the number of the beast, for it is in the number of a man, and his number is 600." 666, which is Revelation 13:18, as you put here. And the first sentence, which again caught my attention, was the number 666 is more than ever present in the financial world. Could you explain that for us?
Well, it's going to be an economical mark. You know, mm-hmm. Right now we see a lot of types, like, you know, those little chips. God works with types and patterns. So the chip we're seeing right now are just types and patterns of the real thing. And a lot of people say, oh, this is the mark of the beast, some hesitate, but it's not. It's not. When it's going to be the mark of the beast, unless you have it, you can neither buy nor sell nor trade. This will be the mark of the beast. And of course, everybody, I believe, will be all